If one of these rounds of experimentation that our customers run go south, like, we just cost them $2 million.
So getting into generative AI and protein designs, how does that work?
Yeah. So, I mean, let's start maybe with what proteins are. So proteins are little machines that live inside of cells, and you can use them for many different things. You can make drugs, for example. About 60% of our current medicines are made from proteins. But, you know, also food products. You can make chemicals. You can make ingredients. And you can make them without using cows or oil or sort of some of the things that we probably should be using less of. And very similar to how you might have an image model where you say, hey, make me an image or a video, we basically say, make me a molecule that does X, Y, and Z. So it's very similar to these types of generative AI techniques. Our users are scientists that work in the research and development departments of, like, large pharmaceutical companies, large chemical companies. And, you know, what they do is they make their products, they design their products with our tools.
Very cool. This is changing the industry.
We hope to, yeah, we're 2 years old, so, you know, and it's an industry that obviously takes a while, because before a drug is into the market, that is obviously a 10-year endeavor, but, you know, our customers are quite happy, we're growing fast, and, you know, the evidence that we are seeing is that it's accelerating a lot of these R&D processes significantly. You know, and that makes me quite excited. Like, it starts with creating value for customers, and then growth will come after that. You know, we started selling our product in the summer, last summer. And so, you know, we're still quite early on this journey. And I think even a lot of customers, like probably yours, are sometimes skeptical about, will this actually work? And you can sort of imagine, you know, in the case of a chat bot in a call center, you can try that out with three or four people. In our case, you know, if one of these rounds of experimentation that our customers run go south, like, we just cost them $2 million, yeah. Right? And so the bar is quite high to sort of demonstrate that you can actually have value. But yeah, I do believe that this is the future. If we can start building more things with biology, that could be a pretty major thing. And I'm very excited about that future.
Can we get more into the detail of how AI is facilitating that journey of protein designs and how you're changing the industry using generative AI?
Yeah, for sure. Maybe let's make an analogy to human language, because it's actually quite similar to human language. So the way that a human language model for, like, a chatbot is effectively trained is by removing words. So you might say something like, Google is a bleep. And if the model would say bakery, it's like, right? Cloud provider, beep, right? At points, like, that worked well. You can do something very similar with DNA, because DNA is ultimately a bit of a programming language. And so you can be like, C-T-A-G, bleep, 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 right? And if it fills it incorrectly, it gets points. Now, we can turn that process around, and then we can generate DNA as well, or DNA code, very similar to how we can generate human language. So that's how it works.
Amazing. So how does Google Cloud technology really help you, both in terms of go-to-market, but also in terms of the technology itself, and Gen AI specifically?
So there's a couple of places. Like, first of all, you know, obviously we have a group of developers that need to not only make machine learning models, they need to interface with laboratories. You know, we have people building front-end applications, and I think the breadth of services that are provided through Google Cloud is really quite amazing. It's very flexible to get things onboarded, super accessible. But there are two things I think I would particularly highlight for us. The first thing is, we work with some of the most sensitive IP on the planet. In the sense that if you have a sequence of a drug that can cure cancer and you lose that sequence, somebody's going to be very pissed off, right? And so we've actually been building off of very well-established Google security technologies like BeyondCorp and others to make sure that we really protect the IP of our customers, because that's really very important to us. I think secondly, we need to, you know, there are no foundational protein models, or at least these need to be built. And so in our case, we use TPUs as well as a lot of the sort of more bare metal part of the Google Cloud stack to be able to scale and train models at that scale, which has been super helpful.